I want to teach some important things that are in GarageBand that you will need if you are producing. I want to teach you how to bounce your tracks in place in GarageBand, which is really important because it cuts CPU. So you may have a MacBook that may not have a lot of space and gigs, and this is a way to cut that. I'm also going to teach you how to join all of your MIDI regions into one track, okay? So if that's something you want to do. And I'm also going to show you how to convert your MIDI tracks to the library. I'm also going to show you how to convert your MIDI tracks, even if you have an audio track. I'm going to show you how to export that to the loop library so it will be always available to you and you can reuse it in different songs and in different projects. So the first thing we're going to do is learn how to join all of our MIDI tracks, okay? So that may be something you want to do. So it's pretty simple. All you have to do is hold down shift, hold each track like that, and then you want to press Command J, and that's that, okay? So that was pretty simple, right? So if you want to do this again, all you have to do is that same thing, and you do this by holding down shift and selecting all of the tracks that you want to be merged. And then you go to edit, and then you go to join regions. So as you can see, Command J, that's the shortcut. Boom, so now you got. Let me show you how to add this to the loop library. So if you want to add this to your loop library so you can use it again, all you have to do is go to File, Add Region to Loop Library, and you can name this what you want. So I'm going to name it R&B Drum Loop Meek, because that's my name. You want to make sure you put your name so you know that you're the creator, okay? And then, so the type is a loop. You can select scale, genre, or key. I'm going to select hip-hop and R&B. And then here, you can select your instrument descriptors. Okay, so we know that this is a drum loop, so we can put all drums. Now, if you want, you can put percussion too. And then you can put it as a kit, beats, and all of those things. So, but all drums. You could just select all drums, and it'll go to all drums. And I'm going to select beats because it's a beat loop, right? I got a snare, I got a hi-hat, and I got a kick. But it's a beat too, so I'm put beats. And then you can select like more descriptors when you're looking for it. So you can select more than one descriptor. So I think it's grooving. I think it's relaxed, clean. But yeah, and then you go to create. All right. And so, yeah, you've seen that. It just loaded and it was adding it to the loop library. So you go to your loop library. So if you go to the loop library and you go to My Loops, right? You go to My Loops and there it is. And you can always, if you want to, just drag that over. Now you got your loop, okay? So what I'm gonna do is now teach you how to bounce your loop into an audio file. So the first thing you wanna do, we got our loop, of course, and then you wanna go to Share. And then you wanna go to Export Song to Disk, okay? And I'm gonna choose WAV file because WAV file is great quality. But if you're doing something like for games and stuff, you know, choose at your, you know, discretion. Drum loop. I'm going to save it as R&B drum loop, okay, because it's clear and it's saving to my downloads. You can choose more folders. You can choose any folder, but I'm going to put downloads. Usually I'll save it on my external. So actually I'm going to save it to my external just so you guys can see. All right, so I'm going to save it to my external drive, uncompressed. Okay, then we're going to go export. So then we just drag and drop it in. So now I just drag and drop it into GarageBand. So I have the loop here. Okay, R&B drum loop dot wave. Just drag and drop it in there. It should be blue because it's audio. So there we have it. So we can also add this to the loop library by going to File. You have to make sure you have this click though. You have to make sure you have your stem click because if you don't, this is going to be grayed out. So you want to make sure you have that highlighted. And then you go to Add to Loop Library. Same thing, R&B drum loop audio file. We just go to all drums, beats, and then you can add everything you want, relax, and all the things. And now you have it. There you go, right there. So that is how you add a audio loop to your loop library, and that is how you bounce your MIDI to an audio file. One more thing, let's go back. There we go. I would suggest if you like your drum pattern, you can just add that to the loop library by itself. Add to loop library, the drum pattern, R&B, Meek, and then all drums, and then you go to kick, and you can go to clean, and grooving, and genre, you can pick a genre, hip hop and R&B, and you can just add it like that. Oh, there you go. And you can add all of these individually to your loop library. I kind of really already did it, but yeah, so I got my snare pattern. Right, and then I got my hi-hats. And if you drag that over there, it's gonna be the same MIDI pattern. Yeah, so that's that. Thank you for watching. I hope that helps. It's simple, but it's good information.